OpenAI just revealed that you can build AI agents using their new responses API that includes web search, file search, and even the ability to control your own computer. So we're going to learn in this video how to use these features to develop autonomous AI agents, perfect for you if you're a no-code builder, and I want to simplify it. So hopefully by the end of this video, you'll be building your own AI agent using the new releases from OpenAI. Now, we're going to use Cursor AI because it's a brilliant no-code tool, and I've actually gone ahead and trained in all the documentation from OpenAI into my Cursor rules. Now, you can access this by going to Settings. That's up in the top right of Cursor. And then you go to Rules over here. And when you go to Rules, you'll see there are project rules. Now, I've trained in the Python Agents SDK from OpenAI and also the Responses API from OpenAI. If you want to get these rules and use them for yourself, they're in the premium section of my community. Just use the link down below, join up, and we'll also discuss how to use these powerful new features. Now, let's get straight to it. Close down those rules. This project will now follow all the best practices from OpenAI. Let's say create an AI agent using the OpenAI Agents SDK that searches through my YouTube transcripts. I'll upload those to a vector store, which, by the way, OpenAI just announced this cool vector store, which is kind of like a really cool RAG database. If you haven't seen my videos about Quadrant and previous videos about making AI agents, this is pretty groundbreaking in itself. So I'll upload those, and then it provides answers based on what I said in my videos. Call it Agent Magic, and also make a nice web interface to chat with it. And as always, I like to ask for the valuation of simplicity, because often when I type something into Cursor, it goes completely crazy and goes over the top. Okay, it says, I'll help you do this, and it's even reading the rules now, which is a great sign. It's paying attention to exactly how to use OpenAI's new release to make this agent for me. It's thinking about it very hard, and now it's exploring what's already there so it can go ahead and create my first AI agent. Okay, first I'll run this command to get it up and running. Now it's creating a requirements file so it can install dependencies. Even the brand new OpenAI-agents is included, so this really is listening to the rules. And now you can see it's creating a Flask web application. This will essentially give a website where I can interact with my agent. Finally, it's created an env.example file, which is where I'll put my OpenAI API key. Now look at this. It's funny because it stops running the agent in Cursor after 25 tool calls, but will resume and let it keep generating until it finishes my AI agent. It's even making something to create a Docker image of this app. This is absolutely insane. That's amazing. In just one prompt, all of this code here has been created. That's nuts. So I guess now I'll go and get an API key from OpenAI. Let's create something, and we'll call this Agent Magic, and just create a secret key. Then we'll copy that key and paste it into, well, I'll copy this and make a proper ENV file. So let's rename that to .env. And then we'll paste the OpenAI key in here. Okay, with that done, let's take a look at the README to see what is mentioned here. Now everything's up and running. Let's run the Python command and see if it works. And I can't believe this. It is working. Okay, wow. Agent Magic, ask questions about your YouTube videos. What do you know? And remember, these are only sample transcripts at the moment. I'm here to help you find information from your YouTube transcripts if you have a specific question. So this is actually working. Okay, tell me how to make a great video. What is coming back? I'm experiencing trouble accessing the transcripts. Okay, every time I try to ask it a question, it tells me it's having some trouble accessing the video transcripts. Now, I think this is because you've got to actually upload these transcripts to the OpenAI vector store in the OpenAI developer playground. So let's try that. So here I am in the OpenAI developer playground, and I'm going to go to storage here, and you'll see vector stores. This is new vector stores up here, and then you can create your first vector store. So like I said at the start of the video, this is like a RAG database. I might not need Quadrant or AI Mic anymore. I can just do it like this. So let's call this AI Mic Open AI, and that's a tick. Now, this is important. This is our vector store ID that we're going to need to give to Cursor. And I guess I can add files. So let's try that. Okay. Drag your files here or click upload. I've gone here to my transcriptions folder. I've got all of my YouTube video transcripts downloaded. And let's just grab a few of them, maybe back to the start of 2025. And let's see if we can drag and drop. Yep, it's uploaded all of those transcripts. So we'll attach. And now it looks like all of those will be, yes, they're in my vector store inside my OpenAI account. This is great news. Now, even though this app seems to be working, I'm going to go to the chat here and say, the transcripts can't be found by the agent. I think we need to reference a vector store ID from OpenAI. Mine is, and then there's my little vector store ID. Can we put that in the EMV example and use it throughout the code? So it's doing a few checks. It's looking at the main code setup. Now it's looking at the main agent.py file and the vector store file as well. Very important. And it's reading my .env. It's going to go ahead and update everything. There we go. Vector store ID needed. It's even editing my actual .env file, which is cool. And finally, it's editing agent.py. That's just to make sure vector store is called by my agent magic. Okay, I think it's done. So let's try and run that Python file again. And yes, it's booted back up and let's open it up. Okay, this is our second attempt at agent magic. So what do you know about OpenAI? Wow. OpenAI recently announced the release of ChatGPT 4.5, which is in research preview. This is exactly what I said in a video just a week or so ago. It is now directly calling the files I've put in my vector store and agentically presenting them to me right here inside the Agent Magic interface. This is cool. Focusing on emotional intelligence and effectiveness. Wow, wow, wow. Okay, let's get more personal. Thoughts on Elon Musk. And it says here, the transcripts don't have a detailed section directly discussing Elon Musk. Okay, that's good, because actually, maybe I haven't mentioned Elon in 2025 so far. But now, obviously, in this video, I have. Let's try another question. And this one should be an easy one. What did you say about Zapier recently? Of course, I've done a video under 2 weeks ago about Zapier, using it for online trading. Recently, Zapier was mentioned in the context of an AI trading bot. Wow, this is cool. Literally, I can replace my whole stack. I was using Quadrant and all kinds of other automation tools to make an AI agent work. But now with the OpenAI Agents SDK and Responses API, I can throw all of my transcripts into a vector store right inside OpenAI, and then I can code something using the rules that I will provide in the premium section of my community linked up down below. This is absolutely nuts. Let's try a little tougher one now. What is the name of your channel? And see if it gets that one right. Again, Agent Magic is searching through. The name of the channel is Creator Magic. It's a leading YouTube channel focused on AI-powered content creation with consistent weekly updates. No way. OpenAI agents are totally insane. And if you're a no-code enthusiast using tools like Cursor, you gotta try this right now. Okay, let's next level this and add another agentic feature from OpenAI's new release. It can do file search perfectly well. I think we've proved that. But what about web search? Yes, the AI agents from OpenAI have the ability to do that. So I'm gonna add in here another prompt to Cursor saying, in addition to file search via the vector store, give the AI agent the web search ability. Clearly note this with a cool animation in the web UI showing it's doing an online search. Only do a web search if you want to present more up-to-date information for a query. So essentially, we're giving the agent autonomy to decide whether it can just pull the latest from my transcript and that be enough, or whether it's actually going to go ahead and pull stuff in from the web. So it's looking at how the agent is currently built and understanding how the app works. It's also listing everything that's in the directories here. Just while we wait for my AI agent to build, look at this. The logs console in my OpenAI API dashboard is filling up with all the questions asked of my agent. This is really cool because when your AI agent is interacted with, you'll be able to see all the interactions right in your OpenAI account. Okay, I think it's updated. So let's try running this Python app again. And yep, it's all up and running. So let's control click. And here we are with Agent Magic V3. So let's just say, what is the very latest about OpenAI, and see if it wants to search the web. Ooh, searching the web. This is so epic. Now note, I have not uploaded the transcript of this video. I can't because I'm still making it. So not only is it thinking about what's in the transcripts of my video, but it's looking for an answer. Oh my goodness. Okay, not very well formatted, but OpenAI have been actively expanding partnerships in technological offerings, blah, 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 blah. Okay, and a lot of sources not very well formatted. One little problem before we go on, when it searches the web, the sources are not nicely formatted. Please make them look pretty and the links work. And I'm pasting in a sample here. Okay, that seems to be working. Let's run the Python app again and open. Here we are. Okay, tell me some latest news from OpenAI. Immediately it knows to search the web. I'm digging that animation that's been generated, by the way. Wow, that's insane. Look at this. Not only has it said all the latest stuff from OpenAI, but it's putting citations all the way through with direct links out to the exact news stories. These are real links that go to real places and all the sources linked at the bottom. This is pretty insane. This is agent magic. And that is an introduction to the new agents that you can build right now using the OpenAI Agents SDK, which is Python, and also the Responses API. But of course, you don't need to know any code because you can use a no-code tool like Cursor AI and build these apps yourself. Now, they can be fully agentic, multiple agent processes, and you can monitor everything you've done in the logs from web searches to searches through transcripts. They're all recorded right there inside your OpenAI API playground. This is really super cool stuff. I really hope you enjoy building. And to help you with building, I have uploaded my Cursor rules for building with the latest Agents SDK and Responses API. So if you want to grab them, they're in my community. Just join the premium section and they'll be available for you to download. And we'll be discussing more about building awesome AI agents with these epic OpenAI tools. Let me know what you're going to do in the comments down below. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now that you should watch next.